Hello again. Okay, folks. I was so stumped and at a loss last time about this Pilgrims of the Dark quest. And yes, it's supposed to be cryptic, and yes, it's supposed to be hard to do, as evidenced by just the fact that you have to spend humanity in order to do it. But here's the thing. This is incredible. You actually cannot, I repeat, cannot just use your feather to escape from the chasm of old, okay? That's not gonna work. If you want to complete the quest, you have to beat the area, light this huge bowl, and then you have to find the one pit that you can jump down. It'll have some layer of fog over it. and this apparently saves your progress. If you don't, you have to do the entire area all over again. Isn't that lovely? No. No, From Software. That's bullshit. If I do it correctly, you know, then please just let me go about my way. I don't wanna adhere to like completely arbitrary rules. Like I said, it's supposed to be cryptic, but that's ridiculous. This requires, pretty much, unless you're just lucky, it requires that you look at the wiki and that you look at the wiki and see how it's supposed to be done. And I think being required to look up something is just unacceptable. There have been some things like that in Dark Souls 1 too. For example, the way crafting boss weapons works, or let's say the way covenants work in Dark Souls 1 and also in Dark Souls 2. But, well, maybe you can forgive covenants because they're primarily focused on internet play anyway, so you'd think that people would look them up on wikis. But still, why not, for example, have one of the characters give a vague hint about it, like that dude right there, Dark Diver Grandal is his name. He could have said something like, okay, seek the dark, but light your way with fire or something, or because just for the fact that you have to use a torch there. But again, I guess they didn't expect people to use the light spell, which is in itself a little ludicrous because he's the one selling the light spell. But anyway, or for the chasm, he could have said something like, fall into the deep depths to find your reward, something like that, I don't know. Let's say somebody picks that game up 10 years from now and I don't know, he never heard of Dark Souls being a game that you have to look up wikis for. and then they play it and think it sucks because it has elements in it that are just non-playable if you don't interact with a community, which is by that point maybe non-existent, who knows. Anyway, that's my rant. Okay, apparently I went down here, or haven't I? Let's see, maybe this is where the boss waits now. I have no idea. Like I said, it's supposed to be cryptic, but still. And I die. That was the wrong pit, apparently. Okay, apparently that was the wrong pit. Let's see if we can fight the right one. Bear in mind, of course, every time I go through here, I have to go through the area that leads up to here. I have to spend a human effigy, which at this point of the game I have to farm if I want to do this quest, which is a pain in the ass. Nobody likes to do this if it's required. And then just to arrive at the point where you just you know, okay, I did this wrong, so I have to do the entire thing all over again. That's bullshit. Why do you have to explain this? Dark Souls 1 had frustrating stuff like that too, I admit. That was, I already told you about that, but at least in Dark Souls 1, I think these mistakes weren't made intentionally, because this was designed to frustrate and annoy you. And I can understand some frustration being an element to a game, because if you can overcome that, you feel accomplished. That's what Dark Souls is all about, right? But here's the thing. With most things in Dark Souls, be it quests or getting to a boss or clearing an area or whatever, if it's frustrating, it's usually, you know, an even playing field. You can at least gather all the information by yourself, all the information you need, even if it means you have to be at a specific time or a specific place or talk to a certain character, who knows. If it takes that, then you're still able to get all the information by yourself, right? And that feeling that you can control whatever it is that is annoying you, that is frustrating, that makes all the difference, because you are the one sort of outwitting your adversaries or overcoming your obstacles. But this, it's just, okay, you can gather that information if you want, but it's gonna cost you. It's gonna cost you time, it's gonna cost you patience, and it's gonna cost you, I don't know, in Dark Souls terms, your will to live. You're gonna become hollow if you don't continue playing or whatever. When I complain about these things, motherfucker. Careless there. When I complain about these things, what comes to mind are these fire keepers and things betwixt. Because they, right off the bat, they tell you, ho, 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 you're gonna lose your souls, all of them, over and over again, ha ha ha, you know? And that's not the attitude you, at least not the attitude I was getting from Dark Souls 1, which was more like, okay, here's all that stuff we prepared for you, this is your adventure, this is, yes, very hard. This is maybe sometimes a little bit confusing or hard to figure out even, yes. But we believe in you. We think by making this hard, this will be all the more enjoyable after you've finished it. And that's the big difference between Dark Souls 1 and 2 for me at this point. Because Dark Souls 2 sometimes wastes my time. Okay, can we please have a boss fight now? Pretty please. This is my equipment right now. I have no idea what's gonna happen here. Here we go. God damn it! Okay. I guess the third one wasn't lit yet. See what frustration this is? And it wouldn't bother me that much if it wasn't, if it was just like a little side thing. But this has major implications on the plot, I think. It is basically what the whole game is about. It's Dark Souls. It's about Manus, this entity of dark that was... fall down the fucking cliff. Ugh. It's about Manus and how he... what happened basically in between the Dark Souls 1 DLC and this game. You want to find out what he has to do with Lashandra and everything else that's been corrupting this world and stuff. And it's such bullshit to play through it. So that's my rant. Sorry about that. Just to reiterate, I don't hate the game. Quite the contrary. I love it despite all that. Okay, now back to our scheduled programming. I'm getting Havel off that damn cliff here. Hopefully. And hopefully not falling in it myself. Okay. Who's next? Yeah, Ricard, I know, I know. Thought he was done for. Don't drink again. No more stamina. Okay. Now. Where's that damn thing? Over there. Incredible. It's actually true. They really didn't think people would be feathering out of here or using a homeward bone. Okay, and now to find this chasm. Probably not this one. Thank you. Oh yeah, exactly. Still don't know who she is. Come on. Okay. What's it gonna be? You know, I actually do recall, like, messages here that said something like, I did it, or stuff like that. And from that, maybe you can infer that you have to jump down here, but still. It's pretty much bullshit. Here we go! What the fuck?!
Finally, you're not young. The embrace of the dark.
I don't get it!
May the dark shine your way.
What haven't I done yet? Just tell me, what? What am I supposed to do for this damn boss fight? Okay. So I'm just guessing here, but maybe after you've lit all the three torches in the three areas, you have to then go through the area again? Maybe. What the? Now it says my devotion has deepened.
There is more dark. Dark is the mother of all. All the kings were born from it.
Okay, thank you. Okay, let's try this, I guess. Maybe this is how you enter the boss fight now? Yeah, expected that. Wouldn't be difficult enough if they'd let you skip the area. Okay, I'm just looking for the shield that has the best dark protection. But it's still the old iron shield. I can't believe how versatile this one is. Yeah, but I take it. So, now, let's give this one more shot. I do think this area is the easiest of them all. That's why I came here, just in case I had to go through it again. And while it's maybe the longest, I think, in terms of having to fight enemies here and the amount of time it takes for them to be beaten, but this area is the least amount of cliffs you can fall down and pits. And just for that alone, it makes it easier. I won't have to restart as much, is what I'm saying. So tedious. Can't believe it. This is even worse than Ancient Dragon. Because at least with the Ancient Dragon you had some semblance of what to do. Maybe they thought they could get away with it because it's optional, but this one's really... It is optional, but you will want to do this if... Not just if you're a completionist, but if you want to... get the most out of the story. Or the lore. Sorry. I promised to stop ranting about it, and I just can't help myself. Damn Steam. Again, this was another instance of one of my groups pointing an announcement on Steam and therefore forcing me out of the window. If you know a fix for that, please let me know, please. Well, a fix other than disconnecting from Steam altogether, because I still want to play online mode in Dark Souls 2. Not gonna say it. I'm not gonna say it. Damn it. Forgot to switch my weapon. Ouch. Come here. Good riddance. Okay. Now, pretty please. I don't know. I don't know what to expect. Maybe should I? Nah, let's just leave that one. Okay, here we go. I cannot believe it. Okay, Dark Lurker. What is this? Dark and fire? Okay, I've seen this move from Nishandra. Doing decent damage, but okay. Ouch. What? Came from off screen. Oh no. Okay, so now that we know how to get here, let's continue on next time.